Good morning. In this video I will combine founder in car knowledge with dog knowledge. So this is a boat. So first of what will we tell on the topic of founder in car, more on the investment side, spreading investments. But also on the dog side, we will talk about the optimum in dog size. So first off, for example, I told about this in the founder in car series as well. If you have an asset, you can place all your eggs in one basket and go big. For example, you can buy a big house and then rent it out and get some returns on that. Very oftentimes you have to get a mortgage as a someone that hires property to get there. Or you could do it another way. If you compare that with a dog, if you have, for example, a need, let's say you have a need to deal with predators, being very big ones in animal size, or humans or smaller ones. For example, let's keep it in the animal side. You have to deal with animals of the boar type. You could go like the big house, you could go with, for example, a bully kuta, which is an enormous big dog, sometimes approaching 100 kilograms, looking like a extremely strong and capable Great Dane. Or you could go with a little bit like in the investment side, with a house, for example, 400,000 euros, if you get the mortgage right. Yes? But you could also go for smaller dogs, for example, two band dogs that weigh half of that bully kuta. And they could also deal with threats. The bully kuta, of course, when it hits the hawk, it will have a very bad time. That hawk will, because it's almost as heavy as an average hawk, especially a female hawk, and it is therefore the work, and it can have an enormous impact. But if two band dogs would attack that hawk, in my opinion, my personal opinion, I think that hawk would have at least the same troubles. And they also can easier pinpoint. For example, if the first hawk, the first dog will not have that grip on the hawk, the second can, because the first already engaged and they can work together better. It's the same with that house. You could get one big house of 400,000 euros or get two smaller ones of 200,000 euros. And that would spread your risk tremendously. Because of course, if that one house is without any trouble, you will get a lot of rent in. But if you have two houses and you do not get all the rent, you still have the other house that does. Whereas if you don't get all the rent with one big property, you still have the cost, for example, the mortgage, but you have no income. So it will be purely parasitic than on yourself. But you can even go smaller, if you look at one bully kuta versus two band dogs, you could get like four bull and terriers, Irish Staffordshire bull terriers, American pit bull terriers, that size, for the same weight of that one bully kuta or that two band dogs. So instead of, for example, as I mentioned, two houses for 200k instead of one house of 400k, you could, for example, have a multiplex with four very small houses, more of a room, room plus, and get that for that same price. So that fourplex would cost the same as two smaller houses, or that one very big house. And then you still get the income, of course. In the best case scenario, everything is rented, but if it's not, everything is rented out, you will still have income from those that are rented out. And also, four bull terriers would certainly deal with a hawk very well. As I mentioned, it's the same as those two band dogs. Of course, they will be a lot weaker, but four of them, they will easily control that hawk. Even easier than that bully kuta or those two band dogs would. And then the last point, you could even go, instead of one bully kuta, two band dogs, four bull terriers, you could go with eight, the size of a petadil. And a petadil is not capable normally of handling a hawk, but if you have eight on the, of them, you have still a good chance. And there is an optimum, eh? If you go too little, it will be hard, but eight can still do a lot of control. You could do the same with this house, so one big house, or two smaller ones, or one fourplex, or eight self-storage boxes or something like that. And the thing is also, if you compare self-storage boxes to, for example, petadil terriers, they mature very quickly and they live a long life. A self-storage box, what can go wrong? It's like a concrete box. So minimum upkeep and very easy in use and reliable. The dog you see on the leash is a Boon Terrier, but that of the Petadil variety, so the smallest one. And of course there are ups and downs. I try to give you a balanced view now, but for example, if you have a garden, it could be hit and miss, eh? For example, if you have a very big garden and you have two band dogs and they are both at the opposite corners, it might take a while for the second band dog joins. Whereas if the bully kuta would engage, it would either be missing the hawk, that would be bad, I think, or it will engage the hawk, but then it is there with its full force. The same can be said if you have spread the dogs over the total field, so to say, with those other varieties. Of course, the smaller they are, the easier a hawk will deal with them one by one. But on the other hand, if you just make it a little bit, you can still have all the others chiming in quite fast. And the same with the storage boxes. If one or two get burned down, or die, so to say, in the translation with the hawks facing off with the dogs, but you still have the other ones. So, of course, you will be devastated, especially if you have such quick losses. But if fire hits a house or fire hits a storage box, the outcome is often quite the same. You cannot use them anymore, and very often the damage is tremendous. But in the storage box, in my opinion, the damage will be far less. It could be that there are some valuables stored by someone who rented, of course, but you can also insure for that. So I hope you like this little rambling.
Goedemorgen.
Ja, zeker. Hoi hoi. In this video, we will discuss the compatibility or non-compatibility of the Petadil Terrier, also known as the Black Fell Terrier, the one I have here on the leash, and cats. So, this is a Black Fell Terrier, also known as the Petadil Terrier, the short-coated variety. And cats are also pets that are often kept by humans. And nowadays, a lot of people think that a Petadil is just a house dog, because they are quite easy. Once exercised, it can be quite easy for a hunting terrier to be kept. This does not mean that they are the best choice for every situation. first starting off with cats. Cats are predators and very good at it. Even your household cat is quite capable of killing rodents and also mice, and very often also when they get in a fight with a dog can hold their own quite well, because also the dog doesn't like to get hurt and the cat will bring the hurt because it has claws, it has a good bite, and they are willing to use that in a ferocious manner, and thereby they are often capable of keeping dogs off them, even those dogs that are a lot bigger than them. That being said, if you look at dogs that are also kept feral, so they were once household dogs and then they went the feral way, and like some cats are also still surviving, those feral dogs will very often kill feral cats. And it's quite known that dogs are able to kill cats, especially if they have big prey drive. So the bigger the dog they are is, the easier they will just ragdoll the cat, of course. And then you might say, yeah, Petterdale is quite a small type of dog, so it won't do that much damage. But you could be very wrong. And why is that? Hunting terriers are very often being bred to deal with other predators, especially foxes, but also oftentimes badgers and the like. In the United States they're also dealing with raccoons, which are also a kind of predator. All these animals, badgers, raccoons and foxes, are able to kill cats, and they also do that if they have the possibility to do so. So that could tell you something, and very often a Petterdale terrier will destroy a fox or a raccoon and will put up a good fight with a badger, sometimes even killing it, but the other way around happens at least as many times. So that gives you some introduction. And all the terrier type of dogs that are being kept for performance will have a high prey drive. Other examples will be Malinois and working type shepherds, but also border collie and the likes. But the difference between a Petterdale terrier and more of a collie herding dog, even those that are bred for protection work, they do not like to get hurt as much as a Petterdale does. So don't get me wrong, Petterdale terrier is not a sadomasochistic type of animal. No, it isn't. But it will keep on the job till it's done and will not get scared off. So for example, if it faces off with a fox or a badger, the damage it receives is a lot more than that of a cat, and still it will be on it. And that cat, if they would engage, they could be in big trouble. So if you're still in there and really want to keep Petterdales and cats together, which I normally would not recommend, but if you're thinking this through and you really want to, of course a lot can be done. And there are a few pointers. One is get the dog at a young age so it can be accustomed to the cat and also know its boundaries a little bit more. That's the first point. Second point, very important, is never let them be alone together. So for example, if you go away, keep the cat in one room and the dog in the other, and make sure that they normally cannot interact. Third, if you get a cat, better get a cat that is quite capable of defending itself and also a little bit bigger. So what do I mean? You have very big cats like Maine Coon, Norwegian Forest Cat and Ragdoll that will sustain a lot less relative damage with a fight with a terrier, for example Petterdale terrier. The other thing is they can hold it off a lot longer because they are a lot stronger. Fourth thing, if you go this route, try to give the cat some more escape possibilities. And keep in mind, if you have a cat entering or leaving the facility, very often times a terrier you can just follow it there. But it will be a little bit harder for a terrier to follow a cat in the height. A cat is a better jumper, better climber, but still Petterdale's are known to climb several meters. So also there, this is just another way of buying time. And if things go miss. Also, if your Petterdale and cat are playing very nice together, still, please keep it separate when you're leaving. Because it could be that the Petterdale plays very nice with the cat, and the cat plays very nice with the dog when you're around, because they have some respect for you, and that keeps them from getting at each other. But maybe when you're gone, and the cat will, for example, keep on running away, triggering the hunting drive, this could be completely different. And then you get home with injured animals. But in my opinion, you can do a lot of things, especially if the cat is more robust, it has a better chance of surviving a longer time. And also, if you just keep it separated, there's nothing that normally would happen, because you cannot interact with each other there. That being said, don't be unwise and think, oh, I just have a dog and they get along very nicely. It's just another predator they try to control. And if it all goes right, of course, then you were separating without need. But if it goes wrong, you will be glad that you did. And even a pup can change once matured. Also, cats can change in their interaction. Have a great day.